Hello children, welcome back to our 8th English class. Children, in the previous class, I taught you letter writing. There we have learned the first type of a letter writing, that is a formal letter writing. Formal letter writing is also called as an application letter, where we are used to form a request, like to apply for some job or to convey our problem or message in such manner where we are using application or the formal letter. Isn't it, children? Where the pattern also I have given and one of the example also we have done, and I hope I remember that I have given one question related that I told you do some exercise work. Okay, now let's see that question. Okay, I'll read out that question, check and try it now. Okay, write a complaint letter to assistant engineer, water supply board, Nehru Nagar Division, Nagamangala, informing him to short supply of water to your area. Right, that was a question I had given. Now in the letter, listen carefully, they had not given from address. Okay, so from address you can write of your wish. Okay, but they had given what? To address to whom? The assistant engineer. Okay, and what was the problem there? Reason also they had given. The one is it is a complaint letter, children. Then the matter of a letter is that there is a short supply of water in which area? That was a Nehru Nagar Division, Nagamandala. So somewhere you are from address also they had given, but who was writing letter, that name is not given. It means that you can write a name of your wish, but the below the from address should be given what you have to write. Okay, so let's try from. So here we are writing from. From, okay, from a name we will write like Suma. Okay, and after Suma you are a resident of a area. Which one? Nehru Nagar, because you are complaining about your area's problem. Is it clear, children? Where you are informing complaint of your area, so you must be write that address only. So Nehru Nagar Division, Nagamangala. Okay, this is your from address. Then here you have to write. So here I don't have a parallel line, so that below I am writing date, that is example 14th December 2020, place Nagamangala. Okay, see, this should come equal to the from address. Okay, then to full stop. Here the name of a designation of a person is given to whom you are going to write a letter. There, see, write a complaint letter to their address they had given, that was the assistant. See, this the should be capital, the assistant engineer. Assistant engineer, water supply water supply board, Nagamangala. Okay. Full stop. Then here, respected sir. Okay. These respected sir here I will repeat so that you can see. Respected sir, comma. Here subject. What was the subject? What was the subject there? Proper supply of water. Proper supply of water. From here you start. I am one of the. Okay, start now here. Okay, I hope this and those you have written. Now explanation, body of the letter I am reading. Okay, write it in your composition book. And the question homework which I have given, I hope that you have written in pencil. Now you are going to use a pen to write this in composition book. After writing this, start from here in the next line from the beginning of a margin. I am one of the resident of Nehru Nagar. I am one of the resident of Nehru Nagar from Nehru Nagar full stop. Okay, from past 15 days. From past 15 days, we are not getting water regularly. We are not getting water regularly. Full stop. People are suffering a lot. People are suffering a lot because of this. People are suffering a lot because of this. Most of them are working, comma. So if the water comes in the afternoon, they are not able to fetch the water. Fetch in the sense store or to collect the water. Fetch. F-E-T-E-C-H. Fetch. Fetch the water. All of us do not know the proper time and day of water supply. Full stop. Irregular supply of water makes us to be inconvenient. Full stop. We are requesting you to accept our request accept our request and do the needful. And do the needful. Okay? Do the needful. Full stop. Okay? After that, here you are writing. Sorry. After that, do full. After that, here you have to write thanking you, comma, yours faithfully. Faithfully, Suma. Stop. Okay, this is your formal letter. Okay, so totally here two example we have practiced. So this is a complaint letter. Even the complaint letter, it is a complaint in the sense where you are explaining your problem to the engineer of a water supply board so that he can respond to your supply. Okay, for him you cannot call or you cannot message. There should be a what? Written proof that regarding a problem you had given, received, you have sent a letter. Okay, and by receiving this letter, what he has to do, assistant engineer, he has to receive and he has to put the seal of his designation, water supply engineer, water supply board, and below that he has to sign. It means that he has received the what? Complaint, and he can take the action. Okay, what is the advantage of this such type of a letter, children? Because see, you may call and tell, see sir, we are getting a short supply for water and we don't know when the water will come, when it will stop and all. You can talk to him and he says, okay, we will see, we will do it, and he will keep the phone. After keeping phone also, 2 or 3 days also no water, again the problem continues. Can you question him? Then he says that, he may says that whether you have complained, what is the proof that you have complained? Complaint in the sense, what is the proof that you have informed so that you cannot complain to the higher officer of him, because there is no proof of call. If you write a letter with such, they have to receive and they have to file it, complaint letter. After receiving complaint also, children, in case if he doesn't reply, react to that, you can complain to the higher officer. See, even though I have written complaint, written request, but still he has not responded. Then the written proof was there, so that we are using a formal letter. Clear? Way a lot of formality, with lot of respect we are conveying our problem or request to the respected one. And make it clear, while writing a formal letter in two address, you have not writing anybody name in two address. See, this is a post, assistant engineer, that is the post created. Okay, so this person may be a Kiran, Arun, you, for you, doesn't matter. You are writing to the place. Okay, assume that now Kiran is the assistant engineer. Okay, and when you are writing a letter, he was assistant minister, engineer. Okay, after 2 or 3 days, he was going to transfer and somebody else will come. Okay. And if you are writing Kiran and all, he thinks that he has written to Kiran, why has to respond? Right? Clear? That is why, if you are not writing anybody, you should not write only anybody's name, you have to write the designation only. Okay? Suppose after Kiran goes, Arun will come, then we decide that yes, this complaint has come to the assistant engineer and now I am the assistant engineer, I have to work on this. So he received the complaint. Have you got it? Why the intention of writing the designation here rather than writing the name of a person? Yes, I hope you are clear. Okay, now another type of a letter was there, that is informal letter. Okay, now this is a formal letter, children. Now another one is informal letter. That is informal letter. Vinesh, now take a question. Okay, before that, tell me to whom you are writing informal letter. Okay, this informal letter is other than any designated person. You are writing this to your parents, father, mother, brother, sister, or family member or relative, where there is no formality. You can say hi, bye, how are you, fine, where you can ask. Okay, that is why it is called as a informal. There is a no formality, only where you are conveying your message or your regards to the person. Okay, now take a question. Imagine that, give a heading, second heading, letter writing, informal letter. Then write, take a question. Imagine that you are Pramod. Pramod Bar Pranita. Pramod Pranita. Why this is given name? Pramod and Pranita, 8th standard, 8th standard, Corporation High School, Corporation High School, Bangalore 1. Okay, so when you are writing this letter, informal letter, where you have to keep your name as either Pramod. If you are a boy, you have to use Pramod. If you are a girl, you have to use the letter as a Pranita. Is it clear? So the name they had given, it means that from address they had given. What was that? Let's write here. Okay, now take Pramod. We will take a Pramod name. Pramod, Corporation High School. High school, isn't it, children? They have given the address there. Pramod Corporation High School, Bangalore 1. They have given the address. So these address only you have to use. Suppose if you are using other address, if you write wish of your address, there you are losing 1 mark, because in your question they had given that. Imagine that you are. Clear? So you have to imagine either as a Pramod or as a Pranita. Okay? Pranita. Now, from address I had written, here you have to write, dear. So you have to write to here, dear, you can write a name of your wish. Okay, so let's write dear Vinay, comma. Okay, you are writing to your friend now. Okay, dear Vinay. So here no subject, no respected sir, nothing. This you are writing to your friend, so you'll start with dear friend. Okay, or you can write hello. So now we made it a simple. I just write it as a dear Vinay. Okay, after that, here you have to write I am. Start from here. Next line from the margin. okay, not here, I am here, we'll start here, I am here, I am studying well, here I am studying well, comma. See children, from margin here you start, after dear Vinay, here you write the here I am, okay, after that here I am studying well. How is your preparation to examination? How is your preparation to examination? Examination. I faced first two preparatory of school level and scored 85 and 84%. 85 and 85 percentage. But this result is not satisfied. But this result is not satisfied. Though I am not attending any coaching class or private tuition. But I put an effort of 6 hours studies daily. Daily full stop. And for coming final exam, I am expected to score 95%. For that, I put my effort a lot and extended further 3 hours study, comma. Anyway, I will try my level best to do that. Full stop. I also advise you to frame study timetable and study well. Best of luck. In the same line, frame study timetable and study well. Best of luck. Full stop. Here, yours loving friend, Pramod. Clear? So here you may be thinking, while writing a from address, why school address has been given? Okay, imagine that in this letter they have imagined that this Pramod is living in some board school in the sense hostel, okay, so that he has used a from address with his school name, so that a letter start from here and it will reach to the friend, okay. And see here in this letter we can see that a boy, he was done his school level examination and what was the score he has obtained and how he was making more effort to score for the good result, isn't it? That is what he has written in his letter. And he has end up your loving friend Pramod, and here you have to write, okay, two address. After this two address you have to write here, two here we have written Vinay, right? Vinay, you may give his residential address or his school address. If he was living like him in hostel, you have to give the hostel address. No, if he was living in home, you can give a residential address, okay. And after writing here two address, you can write here date. See, after here two you will write here in down. After writing two, Vinay, date, place in down, okay. That is up to a informal letter. Or you can write here, okay, dear Vinay, here I am studying well. He has written. Or you can start, dear Vinay, I am fine here. Hope how you are doing. Like that also you can start, where you can write your fun time or your you want to ask him that how was he, how was his parents. All that sentence you can add. After that you can come to a matter of a letter. Usually here, as I told you that, finish your letter in three to four sentences. Don't keep it very lengthy so that mistake will occur. You will do strike out and all. So better you finish a letter explanation in three to four sentences. Maximum is five is enough, I think. So that your mark will come in this from dear Vinay, this punctuation and all observe. So don't do strike out. Write neat and clean letter in a one new page so that you can avoid a mistake. Okay, children. That is about the formal as well as a informal letter. And you take a one letter if you want, okay, and practice. This is for your practice, children, so that you will become a perfect. This is a informal letter. One more example you write down. Imagine that you are Kiran Bar Kirti. If you are a boy, you have to use your name as Kiran or else as a Kirti, of Government High School Mysore. Write a letter to your friend describing the Independence Day celebration. Describing the Independence Day celebration in your school. Okay, now you are going to letter to your friend. Friend name is not given. You can use a name of your wish, but two address is not given, but from address is given. What was that? Kiran of Government High School, Mysore. So you have to write Kiran, Government High School, Mysore. From address you have to use that only. And what was the matter of writing a letter? In the first letter, here they have not given any matter. You have made a matter of your own. You have wrote about your exam preparation. But here in this letter, they had given the matter about Independence Day celebration. So you have to write a letter on Independence Day celebration only, no other topic, children. Okay. So like always, use a pencil and write. Okay. From two and all, you can use a pen because that is clear. Explanation part you can write in a pencil. Okay. After thinking that if you are perfect, then you can move on to the pen. Okay. Or else use a pencil only, as this is a practice. And you may thinking that, ma'am, why we have to use a pencil, pen why can't we? You can use a pen, no problem. But as this is a practice, children, better to avoid a mistake. I told you to use a pencil. Okay, but remember that when you are writing your summative exam, you have to use a pen only, and you have to start a letter writing from new fresh page only, and don't avoid whitener or a strikeout while writing a letter writing. Clear, children? So practice letter properly and write so that easily you can score 4 mark or a 5 mark. Okay, this is up to your letter writing, children. I will meet you in the next class with another new topic, children. Till then, take care.